to talk about how to protect your passwords through a double-blind technique. We'll walk you through the process of putting it in your security vault. In this case, the vault that we're using electronically is the Bitwarden. First pass, whatever vault you had, you'll put the first part of the password in there. We're going to show you how to add the second part of the password to a Yubikey. And by using both of those together, you can provide extra layer of security, which they typically call double blind passwords, to get access to your account. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is go over to the Gmail account, and we're going to log into that Gmail account. Up here, I have the password manager vault with the first part of the password. We're going to just walk through the process, show you how this is working, and then we'll show you how we set it up. So we come up here and we just do Control Shift L. And that fills in the first part of the password. And in this case, it's just my password. And then what we're going to do is physically touch a hardware security key. And one of these from Yubikey, it's a Series 5 key, has little contact points on the side of it that you can use. So we do that. Now we're going to touch the key, what they call long press, which is more than 1 second. And you can see it put in really long passphrase 2. So that's the password for this account. So what we want to do is go into manage the account. And we go into security here. All right, once we're in the security section, we'll just scroll down here and show you that two-step verification is turned on. Recommend strongly that you turn on two-step verification on all of your accounts to prevent them from being hacked. So what we want to do is go to the password section on this account. And it's asking us our password again. I'm just going to say show password so you can see how this works. One of the nice things about a password manager, like in this case with Bitwarden, it's just Control Shift L and it autofills your password. Some people are concerned that people can get those hacked. I think it's a minimal concern. So we long press the security key and now it's asking us for a new password. So if we go Control Shift L, what it's going to do is, so I want you to be able to see this, and now I can do long press again, and we'll do long press again down here, and we'll just change the last part of it so that it's easy for us to remember as we're walking through this process. We change the password, so help me remember that. Long pass 3. Change. Okay, so the password was changed. Now what I want to do is just log out of this account. Okay, and we'll go back to the beginning. Mail.com. Now let's go set this up. So I have the Yubikey Key Manager application. I have a link to a video above here that goes through everything you need to know about setting up this app, downloading it, setting it up, configuring the slots, breaking the slots. I mean, anything you want to know is basically in this video that I've got linked up above. Now, it's important too, just from an account security standpoint, when you run this application, for me, you right click on it and I run as an administrator because I never log into my administrator account. So if you're on a PC or a MacBook, I don't know how Macs work because I'm not that familiar with them, but you should not be logged in where someone can have administrator privileges on your computer. All right, so what we want to do is come up here to applications. We go OTP and that's where it kind of defaults to when you first turn it on. And then what we're going to say is configured slot 2, okay? that's called long touch. So, and what we want here is we want static password. Now, you can have this Yubico application generate a phenomenally complicated password. If you click on allow any character down here and say generate, then you notice that it has special characters, which makes it even more complex and harder to crack. So if you, you know, if you want to do that, that's fine. Now in this case, I'm going to try the long press on this and see if it generates. Yeah, it did not. Whoa. Okay. Let's see. I'm trying to long press it to see if it'll populate with the password that's in here. No, it's not. That's interesting. So what's in here? Let's see if I can call this up. What's in here from the really long passphrase? It's two. This is the one that's in there now. I'm really surprised. It says really. It's not working. I don't know. R-E-L-L. Oh, I know what the problem is. What I just, let's try any character. Let's see what happens when we do that. Let's come up here. Let's back it up. Let's do the long press. There you go. Oh, okay. That was the problem. So that's why it wasn't doing that. So now we change that to a three. Remember when we just changed the Gmail account to really long passphrase three. We didn't change the first part of the in the vault. So the vault, you just set up the first part of your password. So we'll click finish here. Yes, we want to reconfigure the slot. So just to show you how that works, even without an account login, we'll come into this text file, bring it up. Let's bring this up a little bit on the screen. I'll long press the key. And now you can see it's changed from really long phrase two to really long phrase three. Okay. So now we're going to go up to the vault. Search for recover. So this is the account that we're dealing with right here. cybermedics.recovermail@gmail. Because we've been getting a lot of requests about recovering someone's account since we've started doing the security thing. So we can go here, and that's what you would do. You would just edit your vault, nothing new here, type in the password, the first part of it. And then that's what's going to be generated by the vault. Okay, so let's walk through this process again. We'll go to the account. I'm going to put on show password. And the first thing I'm going to do is Control Shift L, which is being populated by Bitwarden. Strongly recommend a password manager. I have some links to Bitwarden videos that we've done here in the top. Please review those and consider adding Bitwarden to your own protection. So now that's my password. Now we're going to long press the security key. There you go, really long passphrase three. And that's really all there is to it. That's a double blind password. Now, the one thing I was going to mention, see if I can get to it, back to it here, is when we started this, we talked about using the YubiKey and your password manager together so that part of it's being populated by your vault and part of it is being populated by the YubiKey. Now, there's nothing special or unique about the YubiKey being the second part of this double blind password protection. You could have your own little code, a 5-digit, 6-digit, whatever kind of code you want to add to the end of your password. You don't have to have this key. You know, the key is just another layer of protection where you could have a really long second passphrase or password that was extremely unique. But if you want to go poor man, get a free account from Bitwarden. They have a free account. You can password protect that with an authenticator app, and then use your own unique codes, and you've double blinded all your passwords, and it's extremely hard for anybody to get into your accounts. We're here to help. That's what CyberMedics is all about, helping you with your personal and online security. I hope you hit that subscribe button. We really would appreciate the support. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. and have a great and wonderful hack-free day.